When the promo came out, there was a very funny comment I read. Ki, sir, hum World Cup ka badla Inter Edge mein lenge. So, I mean, that's the sentiment.
Also of fixing in cricket, when it started, how it started. So with all these interesting, it's going back to the roots of all aspects.
Hi, Karan and Kanishk. Welcome to IndianExpress.com.
Hi, Sana. Thanks so much for having
Hi.
Me.
Has the feeling yet sunk in that everyone is loving Inside Edge 3? How are you guys feeling?
It, of course, was a little longer wait than usual because of the pandemic in the, in the latter half of the show. But, I mean, for once, you know, now I just keep telling, when I'm watching it, like, on my iPad, I suddenly, show somebody on the phone or my TV or my mother's iPad, and suddenly the one feeling that gets up is that I'm not watching it. We used to have private links to check stuff and everything. So it's out for the world to see. I don't have to I was trying to show to the world that the amount of hard work that, everyone's put in the show. So, I mean, it's just been, one of the greatest joys of my life. And, and on top of that it's being loved and appreciated, man, there's just like icing on the cake, like nothing better.
Given that you already had the burden of two successful seasons, how was your experience joining the third season, and was it pressurizing, as we say?
Oh, I mean, I was, I've said it more often than not that it was just, I had no idea. Like, I honestly, when Karan had called, I had messaged him about something and he was like, come see me. I had no idea. Like, I thought probably, I'll be offered, some second-rate stuff or whatever. Like, I had no idea that he would really, because I was coming from a very small film. I didn't have anything big, and I just didn't envision that he would entrust me with so much. And for the first, when I heard it, I was just quite numb. And to be honest, I didn't let it, I didn't think of it a lot, because then that can really rationalize you. But I, as an individual, I do take, I did want to just prove myself, and, he's put in so much trust. But in this case, I just wanted to just go that little extra because, you just wanted to prove that, yes, thank you so much for entrusting me with this. I think I took a little more pressure than, I would have liked on some point, and Karan used to often tell me that, listen, it's okay, just relax. There were no pressures about, I think not even once on one shoot day did Karan call me and tell me, hey, listen, I this shot, why don't you take it? Nothing, never. He just gave me a free hand. We, of course, had a lot of discussions beforehand. I wanted to keep the soul of the show because, like I always said, I'm coming on season 3. So it's already in existing. Like, there are two other seasons for it. So there's a particular grammar that Karan has already set. So I wanted to marry my little things into the world of Inside Edge.
What was about season 3 that all past stories have been put together in one season? It was like a family drama packed into a sports drama. What was the thought process of giving every characters a backstory in one go?
That was one of the things that we wanted to work towards, because we had a lot of characters that were very interesting without any sort of giving a sense of why they are the way they are, right? Like, if you take a character like Vikrant, the one that Vivek Oberoi has done, and he played it in a certain, almost like a comic book villain in the first couple of seasons. But you had to understand, why is he like this? You can't just throw in a character and not have any reason or explanation behind it. That's my personal belief. But it took so long and to get to the point where, okay, now is the time to sort of explore their backstories a little bit. And that is something we had decided, going into the season, that now, we have to get to the root of it, the genesis of everything, whether it was cricket. So the genesis of cricket is in test. So we want to explore that, the genesis of the characters and their backstories and where they are coming from. And the genesis of, even the franchise and the PPL. And you see a glimpse of that, of how it just came about. So also of fixing in cricket, when it started, how it started. So with all these interesting, it's going back to the roots of all aspects of the game and of the characters that are in the story. So that's something that we wanted to do, and that necessitated all these sequences that you see in season 3.
And as as you guys have been predicting all the cricket news, India-Pakistan was also one of them. I mean, why the India-Pakistan? I mean, you could have any country playing India, but given that the India-Pakistan match recently happened, where did you guys foresee that too?
We miss India-Pakistan test cricket a lot. It's been 13 years and, you know, I don't think we're going to get it anytime soon in reality. So, we were like, please, let's just give a cricket-loving audience something that, you know, they'll just at least enjoy and pretend that, hey, it might have actually happened. So, let's not forget that it's a drama, right? And the ultimate drama is an India-Pakistan match. I think that goes without saying.
When the promo came out, there was a very funny comment I read. Sir, hum World Cup ka badla inside edge mein lenge. So, I mean, that's the sentiment that people are so looking forward to this. So, it's just been amazing.
And then to top it off, then we use that line in the script. That we can't write.
Tell me, what was the thought process behind keeping Rohit as a homosexual person? Was it important for the story, or you just wanted to play around with the subject that is right now being talked about?
See, isn't it amazing? That's another thing that's happened recently. Like, you have had footballers and other seats come out as gay. Again, we wrote this
2018, I think.
Screenplay, yeah, a long time. It's almost like 2.5 years. Because you keep writing, and as writers, you keep researching all the time, and it's always thing in your mind. You get a sense of, you know, things shifting and changing, and you have a read on a certain thing that you're really into, right? I feel like inclusion and inclusiveness as a has become a very big part of storytelling now, and it's important to sort of do that. So, not only did we just portray things homosexual athletes, you know, in a testosterone driven game where they're like 11 men all the time, and it's not okay for someone to come out as gay. It's not normalized enough. From there to having a sort of trans character, trans person playing one of the characters.
Yes.
Even right in the writer's room, like, we had a lot of representation, whether it was 50% of writers were women this time around, and I'm very proud of that we could be a little more woke this time, and that's really I'm proud of that.
Which is your favorite character, and whose journey did you enjoy most creating?
This is a tough one because I love them all. I guess Rohini is the moral compass of the show. She's the nicest one there is. I am a lot like her. I've written her like the way I would write myself, including the dialogue and, you know, the whole geeky nature of her. And I really, really like the way Chayani played the part also. And she's always a great, fun collaborator to work with all the time. So I guess I'm just going to pick her.
I think it'll be difficult for me to put just one name because I just had such a blast with all of them. But I did have a great time in kind of seeing the one side which I felt was the first time in season 3 was like, you know, Vivek Oberoi's and Amir Bashir's past per se. So those were new people, new characters in a way, if you have to put it. So that was something I enjoyed because there I could kind of like, you know, slightly design it the way like, you know, I had wanted because it was something fresh. So that was something I really enjoyed, doing.